Hi, I'm Lovely, and today I'm going to review Torchwood Series 4, Miracle Day. I am excited to get into this one, but I would like to remind everyone that I will in fact be doing the three series produced by Big Finish after this one. So if that's something you're interested in, subscribe and stuff. And if you don't know what those are, I will be doing non-spoiler reviews in those videos as well. I do believe a lot of the fanbase have yet to check them out, so yeah, I want to do that just for the people who haven't seen it. Anyway, let's get into the review for Miracle Day. Let's get started. Okay, I'm really excited for this one. This one is going to be an interesting one to review. Mostly because of the format. But yeah, Torchwood Miracle Day. A lot of people do not like this series, and it gets a lot of hate. And I can't say I disagree with it, because I understand it. Well, I can't say it's wrong, because I do understand it. But I don't think this series is that bad. Some of my friends say it's their favorite, and I think it's very understandable. I think it's the easiest one to watch. I like the characters in it a lot. I mostly think it's fine, and there are a few things I don't like, but when people talk about the season, the people who don't like it, they treat it like it's the worst thing that's ever been created. they're really passionate about it, and hey, there's nothing wrong with that, but I don't mind the season too much. Sometimes it is my favorite. It's grown on me over the years, and even when I first watched it, I'm like, no, that wasn't that bad. My experience with it was like, okay, that was good. It was a little long, longer than it needed to be, and it wasn't better than Children of Earth. But was it still good? Yeah. And I still feel that way. I like this one a lot. To do a quick summary, because I do want to go episode by episode. I just really like it. Is this team as good as the other team? If I had to choose one, I think I would always choose the other team. But is this one bad? No. I think they do fine. I think they probably do more than fine. I really like Rex. Esther is super sweet. And then, I think Vera should be included, when we talk about the torture team, because I think she's kind of part of it, even though it's brief. But no, I think Jack is at his best. I think Gwen is at her best. Reese is just hanging out. But I remember liking him. Again, I like this series, but, yeah, I don't know. I don't think I have too many complaints, or if I do have complaints, they don't weigh it down too much for me. But yeah, I guess I should get into the episodes now. So yeah, let's get started on that. Episode 1, The New World. Torchwood is back. And that is a statement that will not stop for the series as a whole. Torchwood is always back. But no, what a fascinating concept, Miracle Day. It's like, pretty interesting. And it's a very good setup. Like, what if people just stop dying? And I think it grabs you pretty well. But no, we get introduced to a lot. We get introduced to Rex, we get introduced to Esther. We get introduced to a lot of people, and we find out Gwen and Reese have been living on their own since World Children of Earth. I am really sad the series never gets acknowledged in Doctor Who. I believe this takes place during the Impossible Astronaut era of Doctor Who. But no, this series has never been acknowledged, even when Captain Jack came back to the series, came back to Doctor Who. It gets acknowledged in the audio drama like series that come after this and that kind of thing, even the monthly range, but not much. But no, this one is really good. This is a really good episode. What else is there to say? One, Jack comes back. I wonder if people have a problem with that, in the sense that he leaves and then he just comes back. It doesn't bother me. I think it's funny, if anything. But I can understand if that bothers somebody. Though when people talk about the season, I don't think they say that is an issue. Of course they want Jack, but more so just like, he just comes back like, I'm back anyway. But no, this it keeps the trend of Children of Earth, where some, because Jack has lived such a long life that something has happened in the past, and it mattered a lot, actually. Like, it really mattered. I'd say maybe, I believe it matters more here than last series, with Jack being part of the one to, like, give the, what is it, the 4, 5, 6, the children, that kind of thing. Obviously, they both matter, but I think you get what I mean. I never realized, or I never thought about how much Jack has affected the Earth, especially for this one. I believe Miracle Day lasted for months. Jesus! And they don't mention it in Doctor Who, that's really funny. But no, things that stand out to me is, I think they really get the intrigue of, like, oh, what the hell is Torchwood? Because this is coming to a new audience. I wouldn't be surprised if there's people that have only watched this series. And again, that is something I like about Series 3 and 4, is I like that you could just watch them without seeing the first two. Because there's people that have watched the first two and be like, eh, that's not for me. But then they watch the 3 and 4. It's like, okay, I don't mind that. But no, things I like. I really love the phone call. This is jumping near the end of the episode. I really like the phone call between, I believe it's Esther and Rex. Then they make it look like it's a really short 2-minute phone call. Maybe 3 minutes, but it's happening over the course of like 2 to 3 days or something, and I think it's done really, really well, and it's pretty cool. Like, when you really pay attention, you get to see everything changing with Esther, because they're on two different time zones, and it's pretty rad. And I thought that was always cool, and that happens all the time in like TV and stuff, where like phone calls are made to look like they take place over a short time, and they usually don't. They usually take a really long time. Or when people have a conversation somewhere else, and then it cuts to a different place, and they're still having that conversation, it like leads into it. It's that kind of stuff is always so funny. But no, it does it really, really well. And yeah, Jack and not Jack, but Gwen and Reese, they have Anwen, which is so. This is Anwen's like first appearance. She's just Gwen is just pregnant at the end of series 3, and it's so interesting because Anwen to me is like, oh yeah, that's just a common name, but no, it comes from this series, and it's like, oh yeah, I just forgot about that. But no, this is very American. Immediately, it is American. Obviously, all the stuff that takes place in America, but the fucking helicopter chase at the end. Jesus. And luckily, I'm glad I'm in the crowd where that doesn't bother me. I could just laugh about it. But no, everybody is just like, it's very interesting, and I think this is a very good first episode of the series. I think it's really, really good. But yeah, let's get into the second one. Episode 2, Rendition. I like this episode a lot. This one, the first episode's fantastic, and this one keeps you grabbed. To me, this is the episode where it's like, Jack is on a plane. And, oh god, he got poisoned. He got poisoned by that one woman that's in everything. I don't know her name. I know she's in Shameless, but I've seen her around everywhere. And she's really good. But no, this is a really good episode. I won't mention. I'll try my best to not mention it again. But I remember a friend of mine. She watched. She happened to join me on series 2 of Torchwood, and she saw an episode. It was the episode where the people came out of the film in series 2, and she was like, it was kind of boring. It wasn't. It was this and that. And then she saw this episode. Was like, okay, I don't mind this. Again, she just jumped into it. She did not watch any of the full series, but those were her thoughts. And I think this episode is very, it's a fun little, I don't know if chase is the right word, but it's like, oh shit, Jack's gonna die. We need to keep him alive. That is a big issue. I'll say this is a big issue with this series, and I think any future ones that they have done with Jack. You can't do a storyline where you think he's gonna die, because we know he doesn't. We know his outcome. Even though I think they technically haven't confirmed it, but it's like, we do know. It's a bit weird if it wasn't him after all that time. do you know what I mean? The only thing if I really had to, I'm talking about the face of Bo, by the way. I wonder if there's people that watch Torchwood but didn't watch Doctor Who and they don't know about that. That would be interesting. The only other thing I would be fine with the face of Bo, if it wasn't Jack, was if it was Rex, being like, hey, by the way, don't like, let's say Jack is dying or something, or he like, hey, by the way, Rex, this stuff you're gonna have to remember, okay? Just call yourself the face of Bo. Fuck it. Obviously, I am mostly joking about that. Don't get like too hung up on that, but it's you can't do a story where you're like, oh yeah, Jack's gonna die. Or anything like that. That's not what you have to do with Jack. But no, this episode is really good. I don't know, I just like it. Rex is very, kind of evil early on. And obviously he gets better, I think that's kind of the point. But he's like, especially in the beginning scene where Rex is like smiling when he's having Gwen and Reese separated. It's a little cartoony. And I remember he tries to be a little charismatic during it, and I don't remember it selling on me. It's like, do spousal stuff. Do what spouses do. And it just doesn't work on me. But other than that, I really like it. And I believe at the end of this episode, good on Rex and Esther to fucking kick, fucking, like, beat up those guys. It was mostly, I say Esther wasn't there yet, but she's coming to the airport. But Rex and them, Torchwood, they fuck them all up. And they crack the lady's neck, and she's just walking with her head turned around. The effect is very goofy. But like I've said in, I think, previous reviews, if something looks bad, like CGI-wise or anything like that, it doesn't bother me. I think it's funny over bad. Or I could think it's bad, but I'm enjoying myself. I'm not going to complain about that. That's just something that's never bothered me. I mean, to me, the worst thing that something can be is boring. And there's a lot of other stuff, but that's what I care about most. I definitely don't want something to be a mess plot-wise. And I guess you could kind of say that for this series, but at least for me, it doesn't bother me too much. It helped that this came out 12 years ago. I'm less invested in if it's, like, perfect. I don't know if I'm going to be honest. But no, this episode, pretty good. That is so funny to talk about that the fucking head facing the other direction. That's so funny. Let's get into the next one. Oh my god. Episode 3, Rendition. I think this one's not bad. We're at the point where I'm not starting to remember everything. I didn't even talk about fucking Oswald Danes. This is where I know that actor from. What a fucking first impression. What a first impression. I like Oswald Danes, but I think he's definitely there because Torchwood is supposed to be dark. Like, what a concept of a character, you know? Like, she should have ran faster. Ugh. Like, you know? That's kind of the whole point. And I don't mind his character. His story is a little slow. I'll say that. His story is very slow at the beginning of this. Kind of to the point where you're like, why is he here? I like how they use him at the end, but it's like, why is he here for a lot of this? But no, this one isn't too bad, I think. I don't know, there's not much to say here. The thing is, I haven't been, this might anger some people, I haven't been re-watching, the series too much, because I've seen it so many times. I think I've seen every season at least 5 times, maybe 6 times at this point. That's at least for the first two. I've seen these later ones a lot. I think Children of Earth the most. And I don't want to spend my time rewatching it, even though it'd be good to remind myself. I'm going to contradict myself later at the end of this review. You'll understand what I mean later. But I don't have the time to rewatch these, or at least I don't want to have my time be spent doing that. So yeah. Dead of Night, though, I can't say there's anything memorable here for me just at the moment, and that's just because I haven't watched it recently. I do know we have somebody go to Fight Corp, I believe Vera, but other than that, not much. We do learn, actually, I could be wrong, We learn about Esther's family, right? Is Dead of Night the one that I think it is? Is this the one where they mention Yanto? I want to say Jack and Gwen have a phone call where it's like, imagine if Yanto was still alive. And Jack is like, hey, we need each other. And while they're doing this, Gwen is like, yeah. But then she gets distracted by her family. She has a family now. She's moving on. And I think it's a really powerful scene. And I do believe it's in this episode, but I could be wrong. It's either this one or next one. Either way, I really like that part about it. But yeah, that's how I feel about episode 3. On to the next one. Episode 4, Escape to LA. This one is a good one. This is the one where I don't know. I think I'm gonna say the actor's name right. C. Thomas Howell. Thomas Howell, I'm not sure. I know him from this show, but I've seen him in The Walking Dead as like a little side character. I like this actor, and this is the episode where it's like, okay, he's just hunting them down the whole time. And it's pretty good. The dead is dead stuff is a thing. I could definitely see people doing that. That's the thing. I think a lot of people don't like the politics of this series, specifically, and I think that's valid. But while it is a little goofy, I definitely see people doing that. But no, this is a good episode. We get the stuff with Nicholas Frumpkin. One of my favorite things, it's so fucking funny, is when Gwen and Jack are like pretending to be together. And it really shows how far we've come because I've never, I'm like, oh yeah, they're just pretending and stuff. And it doesn't even click that, oh yeah, they were having a thing early on, kind of. It was all over the place. No, they didn't have a thing, but you know, there was little flirty stuff, even in series 2 where he grabs her hand and looks like and notices her ring. And no, we've come so far, but goddamn, something that should be acknowledged is something that I haven't acknowledged yet is the fact that when you die, you don't you still feel it, and that sucks. Like, that's horrible, you know? It really is bad, and I didn't talk about it enough because it is very fucked up. And we kill the assassin guy at the end here, and it's like, oh God. He's like, oh fuck, he was about to talk, and then it's like, well, that sucks for him and the people that have died in the previous episodes. Again, there's a lot happening, but goddamn, I think the stuff with Esther is really sad, with her sister, not being. It's really unfortunate. It really is. Like, goddamn, no. But this is one of my favorite episodes. Episode 1, 2, and 4 are like pretty good. 3 is probably as well, but nothing like too big I remember from that episode specifically. But goddamn, what an episode. Let's get on to the next one. Episode 5, The Categories of Life. This one is not bad. This one is not bad, and this is when I remember this is one of the more darker episodes where we have created basically ovens to kill these fucking people. And it's like they feel it all too. They're still alive. It's very fucked up. And I remember when I watched this before, this was something that very much stuck with me. This is it just fucked up. Yay, Vera's a part of Torchwood. Oh no, Vera's a part of Torchwood. Torchwood people members, they die young. Oh God. Goddamn, but yeah, let's talk about category 1 or 2. It's a bad system, but that's kind of the point. About how people don't fit in the categories or whatever, especially when it comes to like life or death. It's very fucked up. And no, we have Oswald. I believe it's this episode where he talks about where he kind of shows his true colors. Not like we didn't know, but Captain Jack is like, I know what it feels like to like kill a kid, and it like sticks with you, or something like that. And Oswald's like, no, that moment was fantastic, actually. Like, killing that like little girl, fantastic. Like 10 out of 10. And it's like, Jesus Christ. He says some pretty gross stuff. It's pretty bad. But no, this is a pretty good episode. We have the fucking scientist dude from Lost. And I think he plays like a scientist dude here. Or like a military guy. Either way, I always see him as a scientist. But it's like, no, I like this episode. It's fucked up. It's pretty sad. It's tough because I always, like, when I think about the first seasons, I think about, like, why they're so heavy, and that's because of the death of the Torchwood members. I'm like, oh yeah, we're pretty safe after this point. But no, we lose two Torchwood members here, technically. Esther and Vera. And it's like, it's weird, I don't think of those as the big Torchwood deaths. And that just, it's because we've known them for so, like, brief. But, I mean, they are the Torchwood deaths, of this, series. But I guess it just doesn't hit like the other ones do. But yeah. This episode is not bad. This is definitely one of the ones I remember more so. But goddamn. Episode 6. Middlemen. A continuation of last episode. The thing that I remember the most from this one is the fucking pen going inside of Rex's chest. Jesus Christ. Jesus. Like, oh my god. What the hell? Something I want to acknowledge, because I think it happened already. I can't remember what episode, probably 4 or 5. But we did get the, little cold open scene of the dude jumping off the building to introduce the... What is it? I forget what they're called, but it's people that think you die, like, you lose brain activity if you jump from that height to avoid the whole miracle thing going on. And it's like... They that's one of the hints to, like, oh, where we're gonna be going. And I just wanted to acknowledge that because I didn't remember what episode it happened in, but I just wanted to acknowledge that. That scene's always a scene that I remember. It's like, oh yeah, whenever I rewatch, it's like, oh yeah, we're at this point. But no, this scene, we kill the dude who killed Vera, and Gwen and them, they have that cool-ass explosion. Again, very American, of blowing up, like, the fucking... I think she blows up the oven here, or she does something, I can't remember, but it's like, we're gonna fight back. The fuck you guys think? We're fighting back. Goddamn, this one's a good one. And then we have all this stuff going on with Gwen's father, which, I believe this is the actor from Doctor Who, he gets killed by a Slitheen. I wonder if I'm gonna do Doctor Who reviews at some point. I wanna review the next season that comes out, series 14. But no, goddamn, this one is an episode. And then we have the bombshell at the end, like, hey, by the way, the families, we kidnapped your daughter and your husband, and your mother again. Give us Jack. Wait, no, it's not the families. I believe it's not the families. It's the dude that Jack was with, it's like his family. I can't remember his name right now, but goddamn, Angelo? Yeah, Angelo. But no, we get that little bombshell at the end, and it's like, okay, oh god. Let's get into the next episode. Jesus. Episode 7, Immortal Sins. God damn, this one's a really good episode, and we get like a little bit of an origin of like, oh, what the hell's going on? I mentioned it earlier, I really like the whole thing where it's like, something happened in Jack's past. I think that's very important. I think that's a very important part of the show. When it came to these, two seasons. Like, Jack did something, and we all have to deal with it. And I guess I'm gonna jump into it. There is a lot to talk about, but... Something that is, I think, really big for Andy is he fucking kills somebody. And yeah, it's not technically killing, but... I like that little, like slow camera zoom and, like, zoom and realization of, like, I've never killed anybody before. And, again, Andy doesn't get too much love. He gets a... Hey, if you love Andy and you want to see more of him, he's really good in the audio dramas. God damn, is he good. And he gets utilized more. More than he ever did in the show. But, no, God, that moment always stuck with me when it came to Andy. But, no, this is a pretty good episode. I like the flashback stuff. Angelo is really good. And so is Jack. It's just so fucking good. And like the other stuff I mentioned, something that I think is important is because Jack is immortal, you have to do something fucked up with that immortality stuff. Last season, it was his body coming back to life. This season, it's everybody just chopping into him because they think he's the devil. The devil, what is it? So, like. Seduces with ease, some, with sin, some, with a smile. I don't know, something like that. I don't remember the quote, but they fucking kill him over and over, and then the family sees that. They're like, maybe we could do something with this. Maybe we could just fuck with the earth for a little bit, and we could be all knowing and stuff. But no, this one is, it's again, it's fucked up and it stays with you, and it like, it shows what's. How fucked up it is for Jack. The guy whipping him will never be hilarious, by the way. Everybody's like chopping in him, that kind of stuff, shooting him, and then you just have a guy whoosh, whoosh, and it's like, okay. It's very cartoony, it's fucking funny. But no, I've always liked this episode. And then Rex and Esther come in to save the day. That is, by the way, another line that I think is really goofy from Esther specifically. Your category, Jack. So we gotta keep an eye on you. I always see that line. I'm like, okay, it's kind of goofy. It's kind of goofy, but no, this is a good episode. Immortal Sins. Goddamn, I think this is one. If anybody's into reaction videos, it's. I think this episode is always one that's looked forward to. Episode 8, End of the Road. This one's a good one. This one is a good one. God damn, let me see if I can remember everything. So one, we get to go to Angela's home. I remember when people watch this, some people are like, "Man, it feels like every episode is just like written from different people. Like we just get introduced to these people, and then they die, and then all this kind of stuff." And I believe mostly every episode is written by different people. It doesn't bother me too much, but it is interesting. That's the thing. I feel like this has to be planned out a little bit. It'd be so weird. If they just wrote a character and were like, and they didn't know that they were gonna die next episode, you know, it's really weird. It is odd, but no, this one is a good one. No, yeah, I like this one a lot. So, one, we get introduced to the guy from Breaking Bad, Jane's father. You're gonna hear me bring up actors a lot. I apologize for that. I hope you know actors. But no, the CIA guy, he calls somebody a fat ass, and then he kind of makes his entrance. He's not a good guy. Or he, no, that's just his attitude. But no, we get introduced to the something field. I wish I could remember the name of it, but they mentioned it in a different episode. And what a cool concept. It's like, yeah, when the hub got destroyed, Angelo took this. I guess. He's like, I want that. And Angelo fucking dies. He dies. He's the first death in months, I think. I think it's months at this point. I could be wrong. I think the time skip is after this episode, actually. But either way, he's the first death. And then they're like, oh my God, did death just come back? If so, what's gonna happen to me? And death doesn't come back. But which is a little funny, but no, this is a good episode. This episode has the little blooper, at least I think of it as a blooper, when Gwen is like going off on them, and then she's like, fuck it, say it again, and then they just move on. She fucked up her line. She fucked up her line, and they kept it in. That's so funny. I love that kind of stuff. We have the mole of the family. I never talked about it. How do I feel about the family? They're a thing. For the people who know the audio dramas, I mean, I'm fine with the committee. I don't necessarily think the family is too bad. In the sense of like, oh, bad antagonist. I don't mind them. I like them a lot. It's very intimidating and kind of scary. But no, it's not bad. This episode overall, though, very sweet. We get to see Jack in that goofy ass mustache. We get another Yanto mentor. God, Yanto's so good. Yanto's so good. It's like, no, this is good. We get more with the miracle. That is the thing with the season. Last series had five episodes, and it's paced very well. We're on episode 8. We're on episode 8. But no, yeah, this is a slower, it is a slower series, obviously. It gets stretched out a little bit. And it does bother me, but it doesn't, like, ruin the series for me. But it should be acknowledged that it is a little, like, stretched. But no, this one is good. Jack gets shot at the end, and they're like, oh my god, is he close to dying? Obviously, he's not going to die now, but he wasn't going to die at all, so it's like, okay, I guess. It's like, okay, I guess. But yeah, no, this is a good episode. Good episode. Episode 9, The Gathering. You may notice that I'm not mentioning a lot of the plot, like all the Oswald stuff, all the stuff with Jilly Kitzinger, I think I said that right. I'm not mentioning a lot of that, because I don't think I really need to. I'm going to focus on the other stuff, honestly, when it comes to like my thoughts. Like, I'll give like reviews now and stuff, because they're becoming more relevant, but it's like I didn't have to focus on them before. But no, this is... This episode, I'm going to be honest, I don't think I like this one. Or at least the beginning of it. I don't like the whole plot with the dude downloading an app to kill, or to get Gwen's father, like, to the ovens. Like, it's really boring to me. if I'm going to be honest, it's really boring. And also, the dude's, like, a piece of shit, too. He's like, yeah, that's not, he talks about how, like, he's gonna feel more, like, heat, because he's gonna be burnt alive, and it's like, dude, doing your job is one thing, like, I'm just doing my job, but you're being an asshole, and, like, enjoying it, and being kinda, you know, kinda weird with it, you little weirdo. I don't like that plot too much. But no, this is the episode that's like, oh my god, can we just get to the end? And, yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna kinda focus on the end. I'll be very quick with this episode. Jack's alive. They find out his blood is weird. I'll talk more about that later. I'll talk more about that later. Because they even reference that. It's not my blood that makes me special. So we're going to talk about that later. So weird. Really weird. But no, Oswald is in this episode. He's finally part of the plot, like, super a lot. Reese, this episode is very... He gets turned all stupid-like. Like, he's kind of proper, but he turns into silly man with the bear and all this kind of stuff, so he can discover the FiCorp logo, the fact that it connects to one side of the earth to the other, and it's like, one, why would one of the family people do that, or FiCorp, whoever, someone's like, hey, I'm gonna do this in secret, nobody's gonna know, and it's like, okay. I've always thought that was funny. It's one of those cute little, like, writing things where it's like you want to foreshadow, like, future stuff. Like, oh, of course. But why is he doing that? Why is someone putting that there when it's supposed to be a secret? That part's really funny. But yeah, we're getting into episode 10, and I'm really excited. I'm really excited. We also get to see the, do we call it the blessing or the miracle? Whatever those giant walls in the middle of the earth are. We get to see those, and it's like, what? Let's get into the next one. Episode 10, The Bloodline. There is a lot to talk about. So one, I like this episode, and I love the fucking beginning of it. God, it makes me so sad this is the last episode of Torchwood on television. It really does. But no, I really like this. It's like Gwen's talking about how much she loves her dad. And she does like a whole speech, and then it's like, and today's the day I kill him. And it's true. It's fucking true. God, I love this finale so much. I love this finale. I'm serious. I'm gonna be a little passionate. I fucking love this one. But no, let's talk about it. All the stuff with the CIA at the beginning with the bomb blowing up. Fucking tragic, and it's done really well with the woman being like, what was that lady's name again? While they're figuring out who did it, and then she's like, oh, it's her. She's like, Charlotte? It's like, oh, fuck. And Japera and Noah fucking die. Ah, tragic as hell. So good. So good. I can't believe it. We go with Jack, Gwen, and Oswald. They all go to, you know, to blow up the place. And it should be acknowledged. So, They even say it this series, that Jack's like, my blood isn't what makes me immortal. And we all know that it isn't. But then it's still the thing that makes Rex immortal. It's a little bit of a doozy. I'm gonna say this. If it doesn't make sense, fuck it, because I'm gonna have it make sense. And I think that's what the writer said. Fuck it. Do I think it's bad? No. Do I think it's not how it works? Yes, but also I could be wrong. You know? I'm not too, like, I'm not, my foot isn't down. I'm not Martha's dad. My foot is not down. But no, something else to be talked about. Rex, I think they put Jack's blood in Rex, and then they're like, on any other day, I would have died, but this is the miracle. But now you have Jack's blood. Shouldn't you be dead because you should have died? Does that, you know what I mean? Like, wait a minute. I thought that part's really funny, and it's very specific. Like, they do this whole plan, and it only works if it works out this way. Which, if that bothers you, completely justified. Completely justified. I look at it from the funny side, where it's like, that's really fucking funny and stupid. Anyway. But do what you need to. Do what you need to. But no, we get to all the stuff with the blessing. I love how Oswald goes out. Thank God he's used as a bomb. He takes out the fucking family. Thank Christ. Kind of. I'll talk more about that in a bit. But no, the stuff between Gwen and Jack right here, where it's like Gwen's like, you're not gonna be a suicide. That's not your style. And Gwen fucking shoots him. God, it's so good. It makes my heart happy, these two. And I know I'm saying that when Gwen is essentially killing Jack. But no, I love when he gets shot and the blood goes towards the miracle or whatever, the blessing. That he's kind of doing the Abaddon thing, and this is the final season. That's season one, the finale for both. It kind of makes me happy. How do I feel about that, by the way? Do I think it's goofy, the whole the thing in the earth? No. No, I think I'm fine with it. I'm sure it's a little goofy. But I mean, they were using children as drugs last season. I don't know. I mean, yeah, it's goofy, but like, that's, I mean, it just doesn't bother me, I guess. I don't know. It doesn't bother me. But no, we lose Esther as well. She gets fucking shot. It's one of those things where it's like you can kind of feel it ha like it happening. It hasn't affected me too much, but I've seen other people lose their shit over it in a good way. In a good way. It's like, no, they just killed that character. But no, I love all of that stuff. And then it comes back, and dude, when the music hits, when the Torchwood music hits, God does it hit. God does it hit. I never talked about it, by the way. I do like the intro for the series. It's a little much. It's just a little much. But it sounds really good, and I kind of like the hype and buildup of it. I like the music this series. I've been a lot of the music I've been using for my reviews has been from Children of Earth, but it has been from Children of Earth. But I don't know. Maybe I'll start using more. I should mix it up a little bit. I don't know. How weird would that be? Imagine if you're watching my Series One review and you hear the fucking Miracle Day theme. How weird would that be? But no, this is a really good episode. And after all that stuff happens, we have the very unfortunate, if there is one thing that really bothers me, the unfortunate thing where they try to hint that, hey, we're gonna do more, the family's not done. Between Jilly and that one guy we saw a little bit ago. That part is the only thing I don't like. For everybody who I believe they wrapped this all up, that whole thing in comics. I've never read them, but hey, if that's a lingering thing you don't like, there, I hopefully there's some closure there. That they're like, hey, we beat them anyway, and then it's like, anyway, let's move on. But no, we have all that stuff happen, and we're not done. It's a kick-ass finale, but we're not done. We go to the funeral, and it's like, oh, did Esther die? Did Esther die? She's dead, and fucking Charlotte's there. Charlotte. Jesus. But no, we figure it out, and Charlotte fucking shoots Rex, and it's like, God damn it. We're losing another one. Even though they hinted very well that he is immortal now. When he gets up and throws, he throws the guy off of the. Why can't they figure out how to show people falling down in the Doctor Who universe? It always looks goofy, and I guess it's because it's a goofy effect. But but no, it's like, ah, shit, Rex is gone. Rex is gone. What are we gonna do? What the fuck? And then he's like, he's back, bitches. And what a way to end the series. And I'm gonna be real. I think if they didn't do like a cliffhanger, I think Torchwood would have came back. But I think one of the reasons why there's such a want for more Torchwood is because of how it ends. It ends on a cliffhanger. That fucking sucks. It's like, no, I want more. Where if it finished on an ending, that was more like finale, maybe there wouldn't be as much of that want. Like, yes, we would want Torchwood back, but it ended, you know? Where now it's like, oh, what happens next? And we never find out. Show wise. So I'm gonna say it. I'm gonna say it now. Spoilers for Torchwood comics. I'm gonna say technical spoilers because I haven't read them. I don't think I ever will. But I believe they answer, hey, what happened to Rex after this? So if you don't want to hear that, skip to the next part. This will be the final part of my episode 10 review, and then I'll go to my series review. But if you don't want to know that, I'm gonna say it right now. So there you go. That is your warning. How do they handle Rex after this? I think he just goes back to the CIA. I could be wrong, but anytime I've looked it up, I think that's just the answer. It's like, oh, I'm immortal now. Anyway, I imagine they don't tell anybody. I don't really know, but yeah, again, I haven't read the comics. That might not be a spoiler, but in case it is, there you go. I think they just like, hey, go to the CIA, and they don't talk about it ever again. But yeah, that was my episode 10 review. Let's get into the series review. Hi, I'm editing now. Something else I wanted to add is I really like that the whole like final breath that all the people who originally died have. I think it's really good. And this is just, I don't know if this is technically confirmed. It's kind of like, I guess technically headcanon. But I've always seen this as Owen finally getting to die, because I don't believe he could die even when he gets like radiation to death. I don't know if he fully dies there. I always took it as he lives. But if he didn't die, I always saw this as he finally gets to die now. And I like that a lot. I just wanted to add that in. If that is, I don't know if anybody else has felt that way, but that's how I've always seen it. But yeah, let's go to the review. Okay. God damn. I'll talk about characters, but I don't think I really need to too much. I love everybody here. If there are people that I don't like, Esther and Vera are just a little low, but I don't mind this Torchwood team. I think this Torchwood team is pretty nice, actually. I don't think it's bad. Will it ever compare to Owen and Tosh? Probably not, but I think I enjoy like the writing here more than the first two seasons. First two series, sorry. So it's like they're easy to watch. I'm gonna have a lot more to say when it comes to the audio drama because I've had some realizations recently about why I don't like those first two series as much. So if you want to hear my thoughts on that part specifically, you're gonna want to look at the future videos where it's more relevant. But no, I don't mind this Torchwood team. I do think the series is a bit long. It's a bit long, longer than it needs to be. It's a little stretched out. But no, I like the season a lot. This is my second favorite series of the television show. It goes, in terms of favorite to least favorite, it goes Children of Earth, Miracle Day, Series 2, Series 1. But here's the thing. Sometimes this is my favorite series. I think this is the easiest series to watch. And that might be a weird way to put it, but I do think it. I think Series 3 does have a little points, like some points where it is a little boring. And so does this one, though. That's the thing. So does this one. But I don't know. There's something about it. There's something about it that I just like. Some people don't like it. I don't know if it's majority. I do know there's people that actually love it. But no, the series doesn't bother me too much. I don't think I'm gonna change your mind with this review. That's not the point of it. But no, I like this series a lot, and I don't think I have too much to say. I don't think I have too much to say on it. I just like what it brings to the series. I don't mind the miracle, the blessing. I think it's really interesting. I think it's a really good story. God damn. Shout out to Stars, by the way. Stars brought back Torchwood and Evil Dead. They have something about picking up, like, dead series. But no, I really like this series a lot. And God damn, what a... at least for me, what a nice way to go out. I wish it didn't end on a cliffhanger, but it's kind of an iconic cliffhanger, if we're going to be honest. What a good last shot to end on, you know? But yeah, my reviews will not be ending here. I said it at the beginning of the videos, and I've said it in the other ones. I will be reviewing the next three series of Big Finish that have come out. Series 5, Aliens Among Us, Series 6, God Among Us, and then Series 7, Among Us. But I will say this. Those will take a little bit more time to come out, because I want to re-listen to everything. I was like, hey, you didn't rewatch the show. Why are you going to re-listen to the audio dramas? It's because I don't want to rewatch the show, because I've done it so much. I remember most of it already, where I've only listened to those seasons, like, those series, like, 3 to 4 times. And they aren't as fresh. I'm finishing listening to Series 5 right now. I have the finale that I'm going to listen to, I think later today, maybe tomorrow, something like that. But I want to re-listen to Series 6 before I put it out. So I think there's going to be a decent gap between my review for Series 5 and Series 6. But that's okay. And then Series 7 isn't fully out yet. It won't be fully out until July. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do there. But yeah, thank you for watching. Again, these reviews aren't going to stop. If you want to see the future ones, go for it. I think I'm going to review Doctor Who when it comes out. I just have a good time. I just have a good time with this. I hope you've been enjoying it. Again, I haven't done these type of videos before, and it's been really fun to just do. I rewatch these, by the way. I like listening to them. It's like, oh yeah. Man, I'm liking all this. I'm liking this guy's opinion. But no, yeah, I like this one. I like this one a lot. Let me know your thoughts on this one. There's usually a lot of people, I see it a lot in videos where it's like, oh, leave a comment for like the algorithm, that kind of stuff. But no, I genuinely want to know how people feel about this. And have you ever checked out the audio drama stuff? If you haven't, I think you should. Again, it's loving Torchwood is one thing, like, oh, the show's fantastic, but the dude, Big Finish is so good, and I can't stress that enough. It's so good. But yeah, I'll see you next time. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.